Aw, oh, man, come on.
I thought you would just say it.
Okay, that's my workout. That's my cardio.
You doing cardio first?
As opposed to what?
Just yoga.
You ain't done no cardio this morning.
You're lying. I have, and I always do cardio. And when we either do not, we either do nothing together or only 4 minutes.
Well, cause when we be doing it, you be half-assed doing it.
These are lies.
You're half-assed doing it. Then all of a sudden, I got to go start dinner. I got to go check on the food.
No, I do.
Oh, wait.
I do.
Get ready to burn major calories with this at-home cardio workout. Let's do this. All right, you guys, we have Danny and Dre to go through this cardio workout. We're going to start with the feet together doing a ladder.
Hold your head as high as you can, high enough to see who you are, little man. Life sometimes is cold and cruel. Maybe no one else will tell you, so remember that you...
Good. Use some air on that, Dre. Come on. Get up there.
She's going higher than all of y'all.
There's a lot of fine. Really hold that knee up to the chest. Get those abs tightened up. Start working that core. For those of you that have done this before, speed it up. You're sprinting in place. Get the heels up. Go quickly.
What about those of you with bad knees?
You're working the calves. Working the hamstrings.
Yeah,
nice.
Obviously
the arms. Now we're getting low, right? Chest is up high.
Oh, that's a dance move that Kim was doing.
Dinner, come get your food.
But you're golden, baby, black gold with a diamond soul. Think of all the strength you have in you, from the blood you carry within you. Ancient men, powerful men, builders of civilization.
And one, jack out. Cardio, right? Cardio.
I can win.
Okay, we're going to the floor, and we're going to go into a pike jump first. So here, to modify, you're going to be on the balls of your feet, strengthen your lift, your hips up.
There'll be folks hell-bent on putting you down. Hold
think I do. Let's go see what it is. Come on.
Hey guys, I'm Becca, and welcome to my total body yoga toning video.
She might be somebody's submissive. I know that's random, but you know how you said she looked like something.
Okay guys, so hopefully you've made it onto your mat. We're going to be centered up right here.
No.
And on our mat,
like she's somebody
first off, we're
going to
inhale, bring the arms up,
because I always,
and then
it's
bring
always
down,
something.
Bend the knees, and we're just going to
act. They make me wonder, I'm like, who wears a choker, a gold necklace as a choker during their yoga series?
She got choker?
She does it a lot, actually.
I never seen it with it.
And I started, and I was like, you know what? She might be belong to someone in that world.
Not Becca.
Yeah, Becca.
Not Becca.
Yeah. I'm taking a second look for you, and I'm just coming up with the same thing.
That's just this particular one, you see. It's not...
I've seen that a lot, and I always be like...
Did you see it right now?
Yeah.
She had a choker on?
It's actually... Well, that's
or a necklace?
Thing. It's, yeah, a necklace. And she wears it so tight, it's a choker.
You sure you were looking at her mic?
Yoga toning video.
It's not the
this
first
is
time.
One video in a series of yoga toning videos where I'm going to work you from head to toe. We're going to tone up the legs,
yeah,
the abs, the upper body, and really bring it all in nice and tight.
And maybe that's how she even got working with Psyche True, because they some behind the closed
doors. Hi, goals. Welcome back to day 5. Really excited to dive right back in with you to build off of some of the stuff we learned in day 2 and 3 in our sun salutation.
See how long it takes for me to my sweat to kick in?
My sweat too.
Huh?
My sweat too.
But you've been sweating since we ended. I knew mine was gonna start. I was like, it's gonna start when we yoga, and he gonna think it's yoga.
That's because because I be doing the thing.
Oh brother. Okay, then where mine come from? Then 10 minutes later.
Not saying you didn't do anything.
Craft
coffee that sounds like an implication.
Are always searching for the best tasting coffee possible through trial and error. What's up, everyone, and welcome to Yoga with Adrian.
Don't do this to me,
Adrian. And today we have a special sequence for the knees.
Yeah.
So this is a big request, yoga for sensitive knees. This is a practice that's going to help anyone and everyone build more awareness and strength and stability around the knees. And also, this is just a nice practice video for those who don't want to be on all fours. So hop into something comfy. Oh, and if you have a block, go ahead and grab it, but you don't need it. But everyone's definitely going to need a blanket today or a rolled up towel. All right, grab your things and let's get started.
I don't know about you, never need to block what she says.
I listen.
So we're starting nice and slow and take it easy. Just also kind of using this time as time for yourself to chill out, to restore. Excuse my voice today, Austin allergies. Plus, you know my voice likes to fluctuate. So, hey buddy, and then bring your toes to pet your dog. Like so. Okay, now. Gosh, he has to make it all about him. Okay.
You are black.
getting a nice little lube of the femur, that hip socket.
Yeah.
And mm-hmm. if you take the time to just kind of listen, and you can even look down.
Agent's a freak!
See if as you turn your toes in and out.
You are black gold, black gold. You are black gold. Now maybe no one else has ever told you so.
Boys, dinner. Come get your food.
But you're golden, baby, black.
Today, shorter stance. If you don't have weak knees or sensitive knees, then you can go wide.
Let's go see what it is. Come on.
And we're going to come to that nice Supta Baddha Konasana again. So knees wide, slowly the feet together, hands on the hips, breathe deep, let everything go.
I was gonna say my right knee is fucked up.
We're almost done here, so really activate the breath, take your vitamins.
That's what fucked up my right knee. And I consciously didn't type my
nice control of your breath.
Well, mine was tight, but I actually loosened it up.
Can completely change your day and maybe your life.
But then my knees start stressing.
So use this time with me and with everyone else who's practicing this around the world to just
for us to use,
check in
before
we get up off the mat.
I think using your feet is forcing your knees to work.
Yeah.
Just to restore the spine
back,
here.
She said, no problem. I'll double it. Mm-hmm. I'll double what you got.
Life sometimes is cold and cruel, so remember that.
That's why she don't have no Patreon videos.
Her body is amazing.
You
alive.
The mind is powerful.
She don't. She said she's not a whore.
Namaste.
That one again.
Dang, 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 dang. same nigga that you tell when folks in Texas.
Yeah, I get it.
Inappropriate sexual harassment.
So the sexual harassment is somebody complaining, right?
No, because it's a lot of people that don't report a lot of
not
shit.
Report, not complain.
You said not complain.
Yeah, I did.
It's a whole lot of shit don't get complained about.
Don't enjoy it. I mean, what dude don't want to be sexually harassed? It would mind being sexually harassed by their wife.
Okay.
What you thought about saying? Well, there are a lot of men that don't want to be. They don't want to take nothing to do with their wife. There's a lot of men out there like that.
So, that's on them.
I know, right?
Like, somebody's, you know, they still dogging Mary J. Blige ex because he asked him for some more money. Somebody said, look, Mr. Blige, you might do good just change
your
name.
Oh, more money on top of what
you're doing. Oh, yeah.
They got kids.
Uh-uh.
So why is he entitled to his money?
Bro.
I might be entitled to some money.
You know? The only thing I get is when some dude said, well, when women do that, they get half. So I'm just saying, which I agree. However, I'm just saying, given the status, the conditioning of our society, you bitch made for that shit. You need to push the fuck on. But anyway, my point was, it wasn't about that, because I don't fault him for doing exactly what he always does, right? But I was like, she chose dude, and he was that fuck boy when she met, like, she got a track record of, you know, certain choices, and she think that just because he told her he was a church man.
You are black or black or.
He probably told her he was neither a church person nor a man on multiple occasions before she agreed to date him or even much less marry him. So I need for my girl, Mary J. Blige, to get her a show enough squad, okay, that's gonna pump her brakes when she does what she always does when in terms of relationships. That's what she needs. She needs somebody that people won't say, girl, don't listen to the haters. That's not a hater. That's saying, bitch.
Huh? Who needs that?
Somebody's gonna be like, bitch, I love you. I'm not gonna let you do this. I'm not talking about the ones who really would be hating, you know, if she happened to, you know, run into somebody. I'm talking about the ones that will stop her from doing the same thing again. But she is growing as a person still. But what her idea of a man is really, really
skewed,
to say the least. Cause those are not men she be entertaining ever at all. Ever. Mary J. Blige, boy. I bet she could give us a list of people she even dated. A list. But I bet she'd give us a list. I bet they all be fuckboys. How much you bet? Hey, I wonder if she ever not dated a fuckboy. But I bet you if somebody that never dated a fuckboy said something about it, they'll be like, oh, hater, I smell haterade, and it's dancery. And it's dancery. And I don't want to get called out in the dancery amongst the fuck girls. Thank you very much. Please and thank you.